Hey, sorry for the interruption, but we wanted to let you know that this week's episode is brought to you by Spotify for Podcasters. Really cool app. Josiah and I use it for every single show that we bring to you every week. You can edit podcasts right from your phone or computer, so you can start creating as soon as you log into the platform. You can easily distribute your podcasts to Spotify and everywhere else the podcasts are heard, just like we do every single week. You can also create video podcasts on Spotify, which is really cool. And of course, you can earn money like I'm doing right now by including ads and even podcast subscriptions. And best of all, it's totally free. There's no catch. We really love it. We use it every single week. So we encourage you to go download the Spotify for Podcasters app or go to www.spotify.com/podcasters to get started. All right, let's get back to the show.
Radical! Welcome to this week's episode of the Print on Demand Cast. Each week, join the gnarly Travis and Josiah as they provide insight into the print on demand industry and equip you with the totally tubular tools, advice, and strategies you need to achieve success and hopefully have a few laughs along the way. Now on to this week's totally tubular show.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Print on Demand Cast. Thank you guys so much for subscribing, for listening, for pressing play, for checking us out. For those of you that don't know, my name is Josiah, and I am joined, as always, with my co-host, Travis Ross, all the way from Make Your Mark Design in Broomfield, Colorado, on this lovely, lovely Monday. Travis, you know, we've been pretty transparent up until this point because it's awkward. This waffle section has become that way. Yep. Because we don't know, dear listener, when you're going to be listening to this particular episode, because Travis is leaving town to Hawaii for his 25th wedding anniversary. He and his wife are getting away, much deserved respite from the craziness of everyday life, and they're just going to go celebrate. So as a result, we have been just stockpiling these episodes for you. And so typically, if you're new to the show, you will have been introduced to what we call our waffle section, which is basically just us bantering about our week. If you're familiar with the show, you're like, where the hell did the waffles go? And to you, I say, friends, just be patient. We'll have fresh waffles for you sometime soon. And we'll have a lot to talk about because they're Hawaii and the Super Bowl will have happened. And there's just so much to talk about post this batch session. So all of that to say, Travis, how are things going at Make Your Mark Design in a very general, non-specific to a date sense?
That's so funny. I just feel so bad for all the people who are like, they've heard this same opening, you know, for how many weeks? Travis is going to Hawaii. Travis is going to, I swear, Travis is going to Hawaii.
Well, man, and this guy like, just
go already.
Get the hell out of here. Well, I mean, it's strange. It's crazy because this month you're going to Hawaii. Next month I'm going to Brazil for almost the same amount of time.
Right.
But you're going to Hawaii, so we will be doing another one of these marathon batching sessions, and maybe between now and then we can collaborate as to how to make these intros a little bit more seemingly organic and engaging. But I mean, for this, I mean, we're very transparent with you, our listeners, and so I mean, I don't see why we need to put on some kind of pretend it, like, I mean, if you've watched these last two, we're wearing the same clothes in the last two episodes we recorded, so it is what it is. But yeah, man, I'm really excited about this particular interview because we met our interviewee, our guest at ISS in Long Beach, and I think I'm excited because, you know, this interview and the one we had with Jessica is really cool because we went into Long Beach not really knowing what the fruit of it would be. It was kind of a flyer in the sense of trying to market the podcast and trying to organically kind of grassroots bring awareness to what we're doing here on the show. And so for this to be, you know, the second interview we recorded with the second person that we met on ISS that we made a connection with that's been willing to come on the show and chat with us, it's super exciting because it makes Long Beach from a podcast, the POD cast perspective, seemed that it was a fruitful venture. For nothing else, we've made contacts and made friends, yeah. And we'll be able to grow that way as well. So yeah, I'm really excited for the interview. We just recorded it. What did you think? And what should the listeners kind of keep an ear out for?
Yeah, I think, there's kind of that weird thing where, Awkward Styles basically does what I do, just on a much larger scale.
So, yeah.
Again, being totally transparent, I'm like, well, do I really want to have a competing company on, but we've had Gelato on in the past.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just like, at the end of the day, this podcast, the Print on Demand cast is for the listeners. It's not for me, And so
yeah.
I'm very glad that we were able to, have Alex on and talk about Awkward Styles because they have a really, really cool business model, and they're really serving the print on demand community. And so
yeah.
It makes sense to have them on our show because we also want to serve the print on demand community. And so there's a like-minded mission with them. So, I thoroughly enjoyed meeting her. I've seen her a ton of times. They have on their Instagram, she's kind of the face of their Instagram. And I've seen her a bunch online, and then meeting her at the show finally, and having her on today, and finally getting that dad joke that we have,
been trying to
get out of her since we met her.
Yeah, you hear it in the intro of the interview, but essentially we ran into her in the booth, and we were like, oh, we need to talk to her. Cause again, Travis was like, I know her. She does all social media, and we need a dad joke, and she'd be totally game for it. Cause she records content all the time. So we went day one, said, hey, Alex, this is who we are. And we're doing that. Do you have a dad joke? And she was like, I'll have one tomorrow. Went back the next day. Long story short, we got our rain check ashed, so many weeks later. So yeah, I'm super excited. And, we don't need any more kind of, waffle leading into this interview. So let's go straight to this week's main event, our interview with Alex Galindo. All right, for this week's main event, we have a guest with us that we met in ISS, at ISS Long Beach, stopped by their booth and asked her for a dad joke. And she said, come back tomorrow. Then we went back the next day. She didn't have a dad joke. So we brought her on the show to finally make good on her dad joke. Promise. But that's not the only reason we have her on the show. Her name is Alex Galindo. We're super excited to have her on the show. For those of you that don't know who Alex is, here's a little bit about her and her background. Alex is the social media specialist, which sounds like a job that would fall into my dream job category. Social media specialist at Awkward Styles, and has been at the company for 3.5 years. She started as a customer service representative for the Awkward Styles online stores. And about a year later, they began building their business-to-business department, where she was the head of B2B customer service. She later moved to their B2B marketing department, where she is now, again, as the social media specialist. So we would like to welcome on the show Alex Galindo. Alex, thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule to join us.
Hello. No, thank you guys for having me on. You guys are really fun.
Yeah. Yeah, we're very, very happy to have you on here. Now, I remember, I'm going to pull back the curtain a little bit. I don't know if you remember this, but you actually reached out to us probably 6 to 8 months ago and said, hey, Awkward Styles is a great fit for your audience. You should have us on. And, where we were at the time, I must confess and must apologize. I completely ignored that. I did say, hey, send us something. And, I did respond. It wasn't a complete ignore, but nothing ever came of that until we actually, got to see you in person at ISS. And like Josiah said, you really do owe us a dad joke. So we'll get to that later. We'll get to that later. I think we should just start, you said you've been at Awkward Styles for 3.5 years. I'm curious to hear, you know, we always ask, what is your print on demand story, or your printing story? How did you get into the industry, Alex? And you can even share a little bit about like what you like about it. What's kept you there, I guess. Let's start there.
Yeah. So I actually started with Awkward Styles. I didn't know anything about print on demand or like selling on Etsy, Shopify, any of how this worked. You know, I'd done online shopping, but didn't know where it came from, didn't care to know where it came from. So this is actually my first experience with the industry. And I guess I kind of, the reason I love it so much is because I started, I would say, from the base. I know how everything works from the actual production.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. To, you know, how it gets to the customer and how the seller works with someone like us.
Yeah.
And I think that's why I love it, because I've seen it front and back 1,000 times, and it's just so fascinating because there's always something to learn. You know, there's technical details, but then there's, you know, how to work with people, how to understand them, what appeals to them, both as a seller and as a customer, because I kind of managed our stores a little bit, you know, with the customer service and monitoring analytics and all of that, like the very basic, though, I will say. I think that's what's kept me here, is that there's just so much to learn. And I mean, what's kept me at Awkward Styles specifically is that I really, really love the culture here and just like how close we are and how open we are to learning and teaching each other. So that's specifically about like the company, but just the industry. I never knew you could be so passionate about print on demand.
Right.
Yeah.
So like I will go out with friends. I'll go to a party and I'm like that one person talking about her job. <print on demand. laughs> This is just so cool.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. It's definitely an industry that, I mean, it's always changing. It's always evolving. There's always something new. And to your point about knowing kind of the nuts and bolts of everything and being able to speak about it intelligently, you know, when I was in the business daily, when I was in the industry, that was kind of my job. I was the person that I knew how to fix, run the machines, produce the shirts, you know, get everything set up front to back, all of that. And then I was also customer facing a lot, talking to people. So just that like hands-on experience really does lend itself to the ability to not only speak to customers intelligently about what it is that you're trying to sell them, but also empathize with them through every step of the experience, because you yourself have either been on either side as a customer or as a part of the business in the industry. But hands-on experience is something that's just so, so valuable to have, especially when you're working B2B, especially.
Yeah, especially like for business, I feel there are things that when it comes to sales or business in general, you just don't learn in school.
Yeah,
that's sure.
Experience.
Yep. Yeah, for sure. Go ahead.
I was just going to do a follow-up. So you said you kind of learned a lot on the job and learned a lot about the different machines and the different techniques and stuff. Did that primarily come just by doing customer service and being forced to kind of answer specific questions, you know, about DTG or about sublimation, and you just kind of had to learn on the job? Were you actually like, did you actually go into production and like learn how to print a shirt, learn how to, you know, do sublimation and all of that stuff? How did all that knowledge come to you?
So the first thing I learned about was transfers, actually, because I started when we like were really more into B2C, and I started in production. So I learned about, you know, the order process from, I would like, after I was in customer service, that meant that I knew what happened from the moment we got an order to what printer it goes to, or how a heat press works, or, you know, how to keep decal inventories, not decal, sorry, like transfer inventory, because I kept up with that. And once I was in customer service, I stopped learning about production, really. I learned more about like processing times and how processing times work. And I would say that I really learned how DTG works and how like machines and fabric types and all that work when I was in B2B customer service, because, you know, there were merchants that had a lot of questions, like, why did my shirt come out like this? Or how can I improve, you know, my shirt like this? And then eventually with our own website, that's when I was like, I was a little bit, you know, B2B customer service, but mostly social media. Yeah. And I feel like I've had the privilege of learning a lot more through there because, you know, you get DMs every day. How do I connect my store? How do I go about marketing? What is print on demand? What's DTG? All of that. And I think it was more like my own curiosity along each stage that really allowed me, because I wanted to give our users actual answers. I don't like generic answers. So it was really like each person has a personalized question. I want to give them a personalized answer. So that meant that I had to understand what's an underbase, what's DTG, why do we print on cotton? So yeah, it was kind of, I think it was a really big opportunity to be able to be in every part of the process.
Yeah, it definitely helps you get a greater appreciation. I always tell the story, when I was in high school, I worked at a restaurant and I was a host and a server, but it was a requirement from the owners of the restaurant that before I served a table, I had to spend a night in the kitchen, I had to spend a night in the dish pit, I had to spend a night as a busboy, I had to spend in every department so that I could learn it and get an appreciation for what every piece of the working of the restaurant, what they do, how it all works together. So yeah, it's incredibly beneficial. So I have a question just randomly. Where does the name Awkward Styles come from? How do you know what the history of that name is?
We get that question a lot. So like I said, initially we started as online stores, online sellers. So the name was meant to be a kids apparel line, like a kids apparel brand name.
Okay.
Styles. Yeah. So that's how they came up with it. I don't think it means like anything itself, Awkward Styles. It's just like something playful, you know. And then the frogs is because the owner really likes frogs and like keeping pets around. So actually in our office, we have little green tree frogs. We have turtles, fish.
Wow.
We have like little lizards as well. So
that's awesome. I mean, it's a conversation starter, right?
Yeah,
that's for sure.
Definitely is. I can understand that it gets the conversation started. So what would you say, Alex, you know, since you're doing a lot of social media, you're interacting with a lot of people. So in your best summation, what do you think the mission of Awkward Styles is? If you had to give that elevator pitch of like, this is why we exist as a company, and this is why we're in the market that we're in.
So in general, as a company, I would say that we're in print on demand because we want to help facilitate fulfillment for sellers. So our slogan is, you sell, we fulfill. That means that we want to make the production part for you easy as a seller. There are already so many things to worry about, and keeping inventory, minimum order quantities, finding all these suppliers. It's a lot to take when you're beginning. So we want to make that as easy as possible with software that works to your needs, with the products that you're already looking for, and with the printing methods that you trust. I would say us as Awkward Styles, you know, kind of in the print-on-demand industry, I would say our mission is to keep good pricing for good quality and to listen to what our users are saying. You know, 'cause I feel like, you know, when you grow, it can be a little difficult to hear every voice. But I think our mission, even if it's not on our mission statement, is to actually care about what users are saying and, you know, grow based on that. Because we want to grow with them, not like, you know, at their expense. If that makes sense.
Sure.
Yeah. Follow-up question on that. What makes Awkward Styles different, or how do you differ from other print-on-demand fulfillment partners? I mean, there's a lot of choices out there, and you know, I could probably list 10 just off the top of my head. That I mean, I don't know if you know that we I'm actually sitting in my office for my fulfillment center, you know? So we, you know, we have, you know, clients that come to us for fulfillment. And so I'm just curious, how does Awkward Styles differ from other print on demand fulfillment partners when there's so many to choose from?
I think it's mostly the thing that stands out is we fulfill about 95% in-house. So we have a very tight leash on our quality control procedure. And we offer one-on-one partnership calls with every user, no matter the size. And then in terms of like the more personable things, I would say is that we listen and we make changes as soon as we can based on that. Like whenever I answer a comment, I'm like, I'll pass it along to our product development team. Like I will literally get up, go to their office and be like, hey, you know, these people have been saying this thing. Like, how can we make it better? But yeah, I think the thing that's most appealing is that we offer, you know, the basics, which is no minimum order quantities and a lot of products, but that it, they're mostly fulfilled by us. So we're US based.
That's awesome.
Where are you guys located?
Santa Fe Springs. It's like in 45 minutes from LA.
Okay. Gotcha.
That's great. Yeah, I think, I mean, we've talked about this on the show a handful of times when it comes to, you know, being a fulfillment partner or any kind of, you know, business in the, or any kind of business model in this industry. The one thing that can definitely help you stand out is the customer service, the personal touch, the building that relational equity with your customers and developing that cult-like following where people are like, if you're not using Awkward Styles, then you're doing it wrong. And that only comes from generating that personal relationship via social media comments or DMs and interacting with your followers. So yeah, that definitely is something that can help you stand apart from some of the other fulfillment partners in the industry. You mentioned that you fulfill 93%-ish of your stuff, or 95 and somewhere up in there. And your website says you fulfill over 150 products, which is a lot. So I'm gonna ask, we have a question here and I'm gonna add to it. I'm gonna pivot a little bit. And I'm gonna add on to it. So what is some of your favorite products, and what is your favorite print method that you've been involved with? You can do favorite and least favorite. My least favorite's embroidery, so feel free to throw that under the bus because I don't like it. But yeah, so what are some of your favorite products, and what are some of your favorite like print processes that you've been able to actually, you know, take part in there at Awkward Styles?
My favorite products. Let me think. I really like the jewelry that we recently launched. I wear it myself, actually, sometimes. I like the jewelry. I like the kids collection. It's really soft, but I really like the kids blanket that we have. I like the blanket that we have.
Nice.
What else? And I like the, there's like these dowel hanging posters, but they're canvas, the paper canvas. I really like those too.
That's awesome. Cool.
Something that's different from t-shirts, because I also love the t-shirts, but everyone does t-shirts, so
for sure.
So you printing method, right? I like sublimation, but specifically I like it on our metal prints.
Metal wall art kind of stuff.
Those
are my favorite.
I agree.
It's so hard to communicate like online or in, you know, in digital form how amazingly cool those things are when you see them in real life. I remember at one of the first trade show we went to, you remember, Josiah,
in Portland,
in Portland, and there were some people doing, you know, some of that metal wall art. I think it was Condi, and they had, you know, all of this metal wall art, and we were just like, oh my gosh, that is
just
so, and
blown
you
just did away. That
with
you just did that with a printer, a sublimation printer and a flat press. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. Beautiful stuff.
It was 100%. Incredible.
So Alex, on all these products, you guys have a ton of products. What are like let's just get into the nitty gritty of like the, what can people expect from Awkward Styles if they partner with you? What are like some of your, what is your typical fulfillment time? Does it differ from department to department, or is it pretty much straight across? You can expect to have this many days in fulfillment. How does that look? What does that look like?
So it differs more by time of year, I would say, by like the last quarter. Sure. But most of the year, 2 to 3 business days. And then around the holidays, that it averages to 4 business days.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's not like an exact, like all every time you're going to get 2 business days or every time you're going to get 3 business days. But it's kind of our average because, like, even, for example, the white T-shirts, they don't require pre-treatment. So they sometimes go in like 1.5 days or something. Whereas if we get an order for 100 T-shirts, that's probably going to go towards, you know, the latter end of the spectrum. So yeah, it's that's our average year round.
Do you see a lot of... a lot of products, like bulk orders coming in for, you know, 100 T-shirts, or is it mostly one? I mean, I'm sure it's mostly onesie twosies, but what percentage are you seeing as bulk orders?
Surprisingly, we do get quite a bit bulk orders as well. Maybe the ones that are like over 30, I would say are more rare. We've even gotten like literally thousands. In an order, but I don't know if I have an accurate number. Maybe, so let's say out of 20 orders, 2 or 3 maybe might be over 5 items of the same product. Especially when there's like an event or like a team or like family shirts, for example. Like I was just in QC right now and there was an order and it seemed it was like for 15 hoodies.
I'd imagine you get a lot of those family trip shirts being that close to Disneyland and all of those tourist attractions. You probably get a lot of those.
Common. But it's also, you know, it's because like some small businesses do shows themselves. So like events. They're called, but they take a bunch of shirts and they take them to the show and they do it with print on demand. So
awesome.
Super. And then my kind of last question, because you guys are on the West Coast and I'm sure a lot of your customers are on the East Coast, have you had any pushback on like shipping times to get all the way across the country? And I mean, have you guys considered maybe opening up an East Coast facility? And if so, can you talk about that?
We have been thinking about expanding into the East Coast because of that, just to save, you know, on fulfillment time and shipping times. I honestly don't know where our plans are at in terms of that. Sure. But it's definitely like something that we see is a need and would help so much. I know it's a lot because like just renting spaces in general is complicated and we have to move some of the team over there and, you know, get machines over there as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a lot, but I do know, you know, there's been conversations about it. I know we partner with a facility over there for some of our products. But yeah.
Wow. What channels do you integrate with currently?
We do Etsy, Shopify, WooCommerce, and we have OrderDesk as an alternative as well, and an API connection.
So when you say OrderDesk, because we use OrderDesk too, we use OrderDesk to integrate with Walmart and Amazon and, you know, all of those ones that are a little bit more, I call it my poor man's API because we don't have an API at our place. It's so complicated, but it allows a lot of integrations. Is that kind of how you guys use it in the same way? So if somebody wants to integrate with Amazon, you're like, oh, sure, no problem. We'll just use the OrderDesk. Is that how you use it?
Yeah. So there, because right now we have the integrations that we see the majority of our users asking for, kind of like, you know, the staples, Shopify, Etsy, WooCommerce. And then we know that there are some people that are going to ask for like a Squarespace or Equid or eBay or Amazon. So while we get those up and running, we have OrderDesk as an alternative. Since OrderDesk already has a bridge with those companies, sure, and we can do the bridge to ours, and it's kind of, you know, it's connecting everything.
Right.
That's how we, a bridge for the bridge.
That's awesome.
That makes sense. Yeah.
So what are some of the, I mean, you mentioned, you know, expansion is definitely kind of on the whiteboard if you were to kind of just plan out future plans for Awkward Styles. But along with that, what are some other things that you guys are looking to in the near future as far as growth and expansion?
So this year, we're really focusing on our product catalog. We're getting a lot of requests for all over prints, like yoga pants, for example, or all over print t-shirts, dresses. We want to expand our jewelry collection as well. And a big thing that we really want to get to this year is custom tag labels, but for everyone. So we currently have them, but only after a select tier. We want to do that for everyone and get more into this new technology with DTG and DTF. So we want to put our spin on it and make it better. We definitely want to expand our product catalog, and along the way, of course, improve our software as much as we can.
Yeah. How many people do you have working there at that facility? Like, how big is the team from production to front office to what, you know, social media, marketing? Mm-hmm. How many people are on the ground there?
It's about 100, 120.
Wow. Okay. So it's a pretty big facility then you guys are running.
Yeah.
I would imagine.
Yeah, because both our offices and our production are in the same place.
Our house in the same. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
Mm-hmm. I was going to ask, I mean, you may or may not know this, but when you're talking about like, you know, individual tagging for everybody, are you guys, how are you guys going to do that? Are you going to utilize like pad printing, or do you have kind of a strategy for what that looks like? Or do you know how deep that rabbit hole goes? Or I'm just curious what you're...
All I know is that it's very complicated because I know it's in one of our YouTube videos where they show how we do the process, and it's like something that's like curved, and then they put the tag and the like, you know, t-shirt or hoodie, and they press down on it. The reason that we've taken so long to develop it is just the logistics of it. It's like the companies that provide the labels require really high minimum order quantities. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that if someone just wants, you know, one t-shirt every week, for example. So right now we're working on the logistics, how that's going to work, how many machines we need, where we're going to place them, how that's going to look as part of our process.
Yeah.
So I'm not, honestly, I don't have too much information on how it works. I'm excited to learn though, because I'm like, I don't know how they're going to do it. Good luck with that. But
exactly. Let me know, and I'll post about it on social. Yeah, exactly. I'll post about it on social media. Record a couple reels.
Yeah.
Once you guys do all the heavy lifting, I'll make it look cool and make people interested.
Yeah.
It sounds like, I mean, from just what you described there, that sounds like DTF, you know, direct to film, possibly, and you're basically creating the transfer and then pressing the transfer on, you know, where the tag would go, and you're ripping off the tag. I mean, you could also do that with pad printing, which is it's more of a single color. You know, you can only do one color at a time with that, as opposed to DTF, where you can do, you know, all the colors. But I would say if you guys can crack that nut, that's huge for brands, for people who have a brand,
massive,
but they still want to do print on demand because their brand isn't quite big enough to go the screen printing route. When you do have you have so many more options when it comes to screen printing, as far as those companies have already figured out the tagging situation. Yep. You know, they've already done all that. The print on demand companies, most of us are relatively new in the last 5 to 10 years or newer. And we haven't had to figure that out simply because nobody expects to be able to do a custom tag on three garments. You know, nobody's expecting that. But if you can figure that out and offer that to the public, that's going to be a huge, huge thing for your company. I think that's really, really cool that you guys are trying to figure out that, because that is, that's a pain point, believe it or not. I don't think very many, again, I don't think very many people are talking about it because everybody understands why and nobody wants to be unrealistic in their expectations. So they don't even ask, but they would take advantage of it if it was there for sure. So kudos to you guys for doing that.
We get asked about custom tag labels at least 2-3 times a day. Either from like someone that's following up or like a new person that wants to use Awkward Styles and they're like, oh, do you do custom tag labels? And we're like, just hang on a couple months.
Almost.
Almost. We're working on it. But yeah, it's something, you know, I've noticed that is really big and I'm hoping we can get through this year.
Yeah,
that's awesome. So we have here, I'm looking on the website here, and you have a couple of different tiers. You kind of alluded to that when talking about the custom tags. You have a free tier and a pro tier and pro plus. What are the differences other than, of course, pricing and the subscription fee? What are the differences that people get when they subscribe to the pro or the pro plus as opposed to just rocking with the free plan?
So with the pro plan, really the benefit is you get up to 20% discount on all of the catalog. And then you're able to connect more stores. So I believe with the free plan, it's 5 or 7 stores. And with the pro plan, it's up to 12 stores. So for people that do like multi-channel retailing or have multiple Etsy shops, Shopify stores, they're able to connect more.
Sure.
And then the Pro Plus is where I was mentioning about the custom tag labels. So that's where we work with bigger brands that have like a certain daily, monthly, quarterly volume. And we offer warehousing services for packaging custom tag labels. They get an account manager. They get like a personalized Slack channel. And then they get tier pricing depending on the order volume as well. So yeah, there's a lot of perks. It's definitely even more personalized as well. So that's the Pro Plus. But I would say like for people that are just starting out, the free plan is perfect. You know, you don't need to subscribe to get started. And then maybe after you get like a few sales a month, I would go with the Pro plan. Because you know, you'd be getting that money back if you don't have like the trial, for example.
And we'll actually share a little bit about the offer, I guess, that Alex is giving, or kind of the bonus that she's giving all the listeners of the Print on Demand cast here in a minute. But before we do that, I'm just curious, like, I just want to know about your day as, you know, the social media manager of Awkward Styles. Like, what are you... what does your day look like? What are you doing? Are you just like on Facebook and Instagram all day or, you know?
I feel like I'm just like doing research on TikTok and I feel like people, you know, stop by my room and they just see me on my phone and they're like, what? I want her job. You know, what does she do all day? She scrolls on her phone. So I would say in the mornings, I usually have all of my meetings. So that's when I do like strategy meetings or calls with internally with our team. And I'm also the influencer relations manager. So I kind of take care of any new affiliates we may have, any new YouTubers that we're onboarding. If we're onboarding someone to the Masters Academy, I kind of take care of anything that has to do with like external PR or content. And then around the afternoon, if I don't have any internal meetings as well, like for strategy, then I kind of take care of content planning, any DMs that my team hasn't gone around to, solving any issues that are easier to fix when you're here in person as opposed to our remote teams. And yeah, it's mostly a lot of meetings and content recording. So I do the more strategy of it. And then I also, I'm like, I guess kind of the face at the moment. So I put out the podcasts, I record the TikToks. I kind of like search around what frequently asked questions we have so we can make any tutorials or any fun content that we may have. And yeah, I think that's kind of like a summary of it. It's content writing and content strategy and relationships with people.
How much of are you how much are you reaching out to, because obviously we talked about, you know, how you reached out to us a while back. Are you doing that still, or was that kind of, you don't have time for that anymore, or, you know, you've grown so much, or like, is that part of your strategy, I guess?
Yes, I still do that. I do everything from writing out the emails that we send out to people on the One Behind the newsletter as well, to finding people that align with our audience. Nice. So I'm the one writing the emails and sending them out. And like, I take all the calls. So yeah, that's still me.
Yeah, cool. That's awesome. You mentioned Masters Academy. What is the Masters Academy?
So the Masters Academy is a collaboration with other POD instructors, like from the Print on Demand cast, who have experience in the print on demand industry.
Yeah.
And what we do is we kind of collaborate to create a free mini course for all of the Awkward Styles users. So cool. Kind of get a chance to, you know, answer questions, what print on demand is, how to get my first sales, for example, how does marketing with demand work. You know, there's a bunch of beginner friendly topics that we cover with these POD instructors. And, you know, below that, we kind of talk about what other resources these instructors have to offer. And they're kind of, you know, if they like how they teach, if they like what the modules are, or, you know, whatever the coaching provides, then they can go to the instructor's page and learn a little bit more about any courses that they have, for example.
That's awesome.
That's cool.
And it's like community building and provide an additional resource besides like our blog, for example, or newsletter.
That's cool. Yeah. So yeah. Is the Masters Academy something that's, I should check. Is that something that's like easily found on your existing website? Yep, it is right there. I just looked.
it has an arrow pointing right to it.
Courses, yes.
Maybe next time I'll look before I ask the question. But yeah, guys, you can just head over to awkwardstyles.com, and right there in the menu bar, the nav bar, is the Masters Academy. That's super cool. Yeah. Well, I just wanted to say, let's see here. Let me get back to my notes here. Sorry. I am all over the place here.
Listen, Alex, he's got like 94 tabs open.
He's calling me out, man.
That stresses me out. What do you mean? That's crazy.
There's two types of people.
There are two types of people. People that have, you know, 10 or less tabs open. And then us who have 50 plus tabs open.
Yes, I have.
Yeah. I feel like it's in mind all the time.
Right, yeah, that's yes, Alex. We're on the same wavelength here. I totally get you.
Never mind.
So guys, so Alex, I was talking about this a second ago. Alex, you know, offered something to our listeners, and so normally when you go to Awkward Styles and you sign up, you can get a 30-day free trial of the Pro plan. But Alex provided us a special code, which is super cool. And you get an extra 60 days of the free Pro plan. So you get a total of 90 days, you know, like an entire quarter to try out the Pro plan. And all you have to do is use the promo code podcast, which is pretty awesome. And then you just go to printondemandcast.com/awkwardstyles. And then use that code when you check out, or when you, you know, sign up for the free trial of the Pro plan, and you can get those extra 60 days. And we really appreciate that, Alex, as do our listeners. Thank you so much for that.
Absolutely. Super, super cool. All right. Are we ready? Are you ready, Alex, finally, for the make good on the dad joke? Because it is time for everyone's favorite segment, the weekly dad joke.
Time for the weekly dad joke.
All right.
I love that. Okay. As a procrastinator that I am, let me pull up my Google.
Let us know when you're ready. We're good. I can wait.
It's totally fine.
She's got it.
She's got it. All right. Hit us with it.
I'm sorry. I'm such a dork. I was
For those of you listening, Alex is laughing hysterically is really having a hard time composing herself. So.
She's trying to get it together. Either the joke is really funny, or the bumpers were, or the sound effects. Yeah. I don't know what it is.
So bad, it's good. Okay. Okay. My wife said I should do lunges to stay in shape. That would be a big step forward.
Fantastic.
That was great.
Oh, yeah. I love it.
I'm writing, reading all of them because there's like a big list and I couldn't choose.
Yeah, they're. We know they are everywhere.
I hate being a passenger.
No, you're fine. It's totally fine. Yeah. So, all right. So you might not know this, Alex. You might not know. Obviously, you wouldn't know what I'm about to tell you. But my wife, one of her jobs is she helps place foreign exchange students that are coming in for the year, find families for them here in Colorado or throughout the country. And every year is an incentive trip. And so this year, last year we went to Germany. This year, the incentive trip is actually to Sweden. And I didn't know this. I was doing some research before the show, but the CEO of IKEA just became the president of Sweden. You've been to IKEA. I mean, everyone knows IKEA. The CEO just became the president of Sweden.
Actually?
Yeah. Apparently, he's still assembling his cabinet.
He must have thought about it.
She's thinking, how does this factor into print on demand?
I'm confused. What in the hell is happening? Yeah,
I'm too gullible. It was really.
It was quite the setup for sure. Mm-hmm. That's what happens. Every guest, the last guest we just talked to, he was like, "Oh, I thought you were telling me a story." When we told him our dad joke, he was like, "I had no idea."
Deadpan. You're like. Yeah, I laugh at my own jokes. I don't care. Yeah.
Well, yeah. I'll tell you what, Alex. We've been doing this for a little while. We're pretty damn good at it. So, yeah.
I don't know if that's quite the humble brag that he's pretending it to be, but probably not. All right, so we're gonna go to another segment here. We told you about this, before we started recording, called the Magic Questions. It's just a list of questions that we choose, two or three to ask each guest before we wrap up the show. So, with that being said, it is time for the Magic Questions.
And she's still laughing.
Yeah. it's the magic of the mouse. All right.
I'll go first.
Yeah, you go ahead. You go first.
Okay, I'll go first. So, Alex, if you had one print-on-demand tip to offer a brand new seller or somebody who's relatively new in the print-on-demand game, and you had one tip to offer, what would you offer them as that one tip?
See what others did and how you can apply that to your dream and make it better. Nice. Yeah, I think sometimes we get so overwhelmed with where to start, how to start, that we forget that other people have done it before us and that they're willing to teach us. So,
sure. Yeah.
There's lots of resources out there too if you don't have a budget.
Yeah, that's awesome. I like that. Mm-hmm. There's no need to reinvent the wheel. You can just improve it and adapt it to whatever it is that you are wanting to use it for. So yeah, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. All right. So tell us, let's see, if you had to, I'm trying to think of which one I want to ask, Travis. There's so many good ones. Tell us about a time in your, maybe not your business, but your career, in print on demand as at Awkward Styles, whatever you'd want it to be, that something happened that it just felt like a complete failure. And you were like, I don't know if I'm going to come back from this. Like, this just, it was, it just fell apart. Tell us about one of those times. I know it's a really positive, uplifting question, but
let's get deep into it.
Yes.
Let me think about this. Like a failure. I would say in my personal career, it would be when the pandemic hit. Mm-hmm. And it kind of really took like a big, you know, just stomped on my health, on my physical and mental health. And I actually didn't work at Awkward Styles for a while because I was a student and working full time here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, I really thought that I wasn't going to come back, but I did. And I'm still 3.5 years later. I would say, yeah, that would like from my personal kind of journey with the career and then kind of the company. I would say we've lost some pretty good leads because of like our product offering, for example, or because we don't do custom tags, which I totally get because, like, you know, although we are working on it, they can't put their business on hold just to work with us. Right. Yeah. So I would say that kind of feels like, maybe we're not doing it right, or maybe we're not doing it in the right order.
Yeah.
Definitely looking back, you know, we started from nothing, from a small online store. So
sure.
I'd say it just allows us to know which direction we need to go in.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cool.
All right, Travis, number three.
Okay, here comes the crystal ball question. So get out your crystal ball, put on your little turban, look into that ball, and tell us, what is the future of print on demand as you see it?
The future of print on demand. Oh my goodness. I'm hoping that it'll be even more streamlined for every part of the process. So like, you know, custom tag labels. And I think that DTG, DTF, and all of these new technologies are rapidly, you know, improving. So I think either DTG, someone is going to have to do something groundbreaking with DTG, or this hybrid type of model is going to take over a lot over the next few years. And I would say AI is really just, you know, kind of one day
was crazy.
So I think AI and maybe this new hybrid technology for printing.
Yeah. Awesome. Awesome. Well done. Three great answers to our three magic questions. And as we start to wind down here, take some time and let those listening, if they want to know more about Awkward Styles, signing up for a plan, where to find you on social media, you know, all of the places where you guys are available for more information. Go ahead and let everyone know where those places are.
So they can sign up for free at awkwardstyles.com. We're on Instagram as Awkward Styles. I think it's awkward_styles. We're on LinkedIn as well. Same, Awkward Styles. And we're on TikTok. We're pretty much in every platform. and when you sign up, you also automatically sign up to our email newsletter. So that's a good way to stay informed with everything.
Nice.
That's cool.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for taking time out of your evening to join us. And we look forward to, I was telling Travis before we press record, maybe we should, the next trade show, we'll meet up, collaborate on some content. We can tell dad jokes at your exhibit or at your booth or whatever. We'll just have a good time and make people laugh. And
I'll take one next.
Exactly. But yeah, so yeah, it'd be great to, we look forward to our paths crossing again in the future and being able to hang out and chat some more, and maybe even do an interview in person with, you know, yourself or a handful of other Awkward Style folks. And very excited to see what you guys do in the coming years, for sure.
Thank you so much. Likewise, I think you guys are doing amazing, you know, with your channel and all of that. I love it.
Awesome. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Alex.
Thank you.
We'll talk soon.
See you. Bye.
Yep. All right. Thank you one more time to Alex for taking time out of her schedule to join us and chat again. It was really cool to catch up with her and hear her story, learn more about Awkward Styles above and beyond what we kind of chatted, you know, there in Long Beach. So it was a really fun interview, really great conversation. And she laughed at the dad jokes.
Yeah.
The dad joke, which in my book,
she laughed, I'm sure you, she laughed at her bumpers too.
Bumpers, sound effects, the whole thing.
Yeah, all and of it.
I'm sure you're like me in the fact that if someone laughs at our jokes a lot, they can hang out whenever. It just,
yep, 100%.
You know what I mean? So, but yeah, it was great. And I think, you know, please do avail yourself, guys, of the offer that she gave. An extra 60 days that's generous.
It's pretty cool. Yeah.
That's super generous and very, very cool of them to do. So again, if you guys are wondering, go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, there may be some of you who are already using Awkward Styles and you're just using their free plan. Well, you're already selling through them.
Yes.
Why not use those 90 days and get those discounted rates for that, you know, for an entire 90 days,
yep.
Especially as we're going into Valentine's Day and Mother's Day, you know, I mean, you'll get a lot of kind of value for that. All you have to do is use the code podcast. Of course, just go printondemandcast.com/awkwardstyles. And then when you sign up, just use that podcast code and it'll just apply that extra 60 days. So you have a total of 90 days, totally free on the pro plan. You can see if it's good, see if there's any benefit. And like I say, if you're already selling on Awkward Styles and you're still on the free plan, this is a no-brainer. But even if you aren't and you're selling on another channel, you might want to check them out. So
yeah. And for 90 days, like you said, it's basically a quarter of the year, three months of the year. And this would provide you the opportunity to potentially find something that works well for you, offers a lot of different products right ahead of and getting all the kinks worked out as far as fulfillment and how learning the systems before Q4. Yeah. And it could really set you up for a killer Q4 if you're wanting to do some more drop shipping on whatever channels you're doing with stuff that they offer. This is a perfect ramp up period to figure out, like you said, Travis, is this doable for me? Is this a good fit for me?
Sure.
And then secondly, it could set you up for a killer Q4, adding all kinds of cool stuff to your catalog that you don't currently have. So, which again, we'll pay, you know, Q4 and the success of that could justify the subscription after the 90 days run out or whatever. But it's definitely a really, really cool, very generous offer from them. So please avail yourself of that. Again, just to reiterate, it is printonemancast.com/awkwardstyles. Use the code podcast to take advantage. So very, very, very cool. Anything else, Travis, before we wrap this up and conclude our batch sessions of interviews and content?
I guess one last thing, I'll just reiterate that whole Masters Academy thing. So go to printondemandcast.com/awkwardstyles or printondemandcast.com/awkwardstyles, right up there in the nav bar. Click the Masters Academy, check it out, see what's there. There might be some cool content you might find some other potential people that you could learn from. You know, I mean, maybe someday we'll be in the Masters Academy, you know, I don't know, but that's a really cool idea to kind of have a content catalog with these different, you know, content creators.
Yeah, it's very reminiscent to me of a master's class, but for the print industry. Master class is, of course, a website where you can go learn about, you know, filmmaking from Martin Scorsese, or I have a cousin who is currently learning about Texas Hold'em from Daniel Negreanu, and he's taking his master class in preparation to come play at our poker night here in the next month. So fingers crossed I don't lose to him, because he'll never stop talking about it. But master class is really cool because you do get to hear from industry professionals about a craft that you love. And it seems like they've kind of co-opted that model for the print industry, which is super, super cool. It's a great idea. So yeah, avail yourself again, right there at the top of the nav bar, Masters Academy. Can't miss it. It has courses with a little squiggly arrow pointing directly to it. And I think it would be really, really cool just to check it out. So
yeah.
Awesome. Well, again, thanks to Alex. And as always, thanks to you, our listeners, for listening to this show. And if you want to find out more information about our show,
attention hotline fans,
there's a couple of ways that you can do that. Of course, printondemandcast.com/Facebook. Join the Facebook group, the community, the conversation. It's growing daily. Lots of cool conversations are happening. So avail yourself of that and join the family. Just be sure, I'm going to say this again. I've said it once and I'll say it again. Answer the questions that you're asked when you go to join, or you will not get in. It'll be a Gandalf you shall not pass moment, but just answer the questions so we know that you are who you say you are and we're not getting bots in the group. And so you can also go to Instagram, printondemandcast.com/Instagram to see us there, printondemandcast.com/YouTube as well. We're on that platform right now. Our YouTube channel is essentially an archive of these episodes, but we have plans to expand and do more educational and informational and entertaining content exclusively to that platform as well. And if you want to support the show monetarily and kind of invest into what we're doing here, if you like what you've heard, seen, you like the content and you want to contribute to the growth of the content, you go to printondemandcast.com/shop and pick up a t-shirt. All the money is reinvested into the show, into equipment, into travel, whatever that looks like. And we're very, very appreciative of that as well. And as always, wherever there are podcasts, the PODcast is there for you. We just ask that if you're listening on the Apple Podcast app, which will ever, forever be iTunes to me, to go ahead and leave a review, you know, 5 stars, preferable, obviously. And then let us know, you know, what you love about the show, a guest that you'd like to hear, your favorite dad joke, whatever. But basically what we're trying to do is just get on top of the algorithm so that people who need this information can find this information. So if you know someone, if you're part of other print groups that could use the information and content that you've heard here on not just this episode, but the show in general, please share it, text it, whatever it looks like. And we're greatly, greatly appreciative of that as well. So with that being said, we will see you guys next week. Same bat time, same bat channel. But for Travis, I'm Josiah, and we'll see you right here on the Print On Demand Cast.
See ya.
Hey, babe. Thanks for listening to this week's episode of the Print On Demand Cast. We hope you enjoyed the Totally Tubular Show. If you got a question or a suggestion for the show, send Travis and Josiah an email at info@printondemandcast.com. Want to be wicked nice? Take a minute to rate and review the show on iTunes or wherever you get your podcasts. And don't forget to subscribe now so you don't miss next week's episode. See you next time for sure.